12 Wolf Builders. It's me again. My name is Lila and I'm taking over this Vlogmas episode. And today we're going to be talking about seasonal hustles or jobs. Welcome back to the Be Muse channel where we make sense of money for young adults because, you know, we're not the only ones struggling out here. So we're here to help you. Some of the advantages of getting a seasonal job is, of course, the most obvious reason, getting extra money before the holidays. You can also sign up for a flexible schedule. And one of the perks is the employee discount. Some seasonal jobs that you can get can range from retail jobs, a restaurant job, and even as a delivery man. So I do know that FedEx, USPS, and postal services are always looking for delivery drivers. A lot of people are shopping online. They're starting before Thanksgiving, Black Friday, Cyber Monday, and finally Christmas and outfits for New Year's or, you know, party favors for the New Year's. So delivery services, I say, is very, very busy and is in need of seasonal employees. So if that's something you would like, or you're strong, or you like physical work, this would be perfect for you. If you don't want to do that, but you do like food or being involved with like greeting customers and you're very sociable, I would recommend looking into a seasonal job at restaurants, bars, and even a cafe. If you're a morning person, definitely, like me, definitely look into being a barista. There are many cafes where you can be a barista at besides Starbucks, mom and pop shop coffee shops. And there's also cafes or like the cafe that Nordstrom has. I do know that they open way before store hours, like at the mall, so you can squeeze in some extra hours then. So when is the best time to look for a seasonal job? And no, it is not November and it is not December. You have to start looking for a seasonal job during the month of September and into early October. The reason why is that major department stores like Macy's, Nordstrom's, Bloomingdale's, Lord & Taylor's, etc. are holding holiday events in the month of October. So it would be best to get in an application in before the hiring event, so that way they can just give you a call and sign you up for an interview and so on and so forth. So let me tell you about me. Personally, I do remote work. And so I decided to take a retail seasonal job. I applied early October and I was called for the interview, I believe that same week that I applied. I went to the interview and about a week later I got an offer letter. I applied at different places like Nordstrom, Bloomingdale's, Uniqlo, and some other stores that I forget what I applied to. After the offer letter, I was called in for training. And our training was about a week long. I was with a group of people, so it was a little bit less stressful. I got to socialize and meet new people, meet my new coworkers. And it was nice because we all learned together, asked questions, made new friends. We got to shadow the salespeople and it was all like steady paced, nothing too rushed. If you do wait to apply, let's say November, there's a chance that you might not get that same slow, steady training. You might just be thrown into the position just because the manager won't have time to do the training with you. Not that it's bad. If you can learn and you like the challenge, that's also great. If you start later on, like in November, that's totally fine too, but that's only if you like the challenge. So places to look for the seasonal jobs, obviously one is online. Or you could also just take a walk around your mall or the nearest outlets. Most of them have signs up in their storefront, you know, saying help wanted or seasonal jobs, part-time, full-time. And they'll usually have like a link or they'll say apply inside. So you can go into the store and apply, or you can go online, find the links and apply from home. And I would suggest applying to the stores that you like the most or that you shop the most. And here's why. One, because if you apply at a store that you don't have a passion for, it's gonna be really hard for you to sell that item or to be happy at that place. So let's say you're not very commission-based person. Some of retail jobs are commission-based. it would be hard for you to go at any retail stores like Calvin Klein or Michael Kors that work on commission base. Or you could go into like an Old Navy, which is a bigger store, and I don't think it's commission based. I could be wrong, I'm not too sure. But you have to, I would recommend going into a store that you believe in its products and that you like the products and that you're happy to be there and happy to sell, happy to help customers. The second reason why I recommend working at one of these stores that you like to shop at the most is for the employee discount. The employee discount is a perk and it can range from a low number to a higher number. So where I'm working at now, when I started out in October, it was 20% and now it's up to 30, 40% for other employees, depending on what department you are. And I honestly think that's awesome because if you wanted to get some holiday shopping, you can get it there and take advantage of the discount. But also, don't waste your whole paycheck at the place that you work at, because you know, the point is to have some little extra money for other things, for, you know, besides holiday gifts, food, decorations, etc. You can also check at your mall information directory or information desk. Usually they have, you know, job wanted posts or online at the mall. They usually have like a page separately for positions that are available to fill in. Also, if you like to work with little kids, I know Santa is looking for little helpers and you can also do that as well. So another good thing about getting a seasonal job is having the flexibility to get hours in, working either early mornings, evenings, during the day, on your day off, weekends, and late into the night. So I do know there are some stores that have extended hours. I know that Marshall's in our area is now open to 11 p.m. every day. And of course, you, if you have a regular day job in the morning and you can get some evening hours, you can, because the store is open up until 11, which is great. And I know TJ Maxx also opens at 8 a.m. on a Sunday, and most retail stores don't open until 10 or 11, so you can also get some extra hours in the morning. If you go to a department store, most department stores have what they call a decorating party, and it's where you come in after business hours to decorate the whole department store. Usually these hours at a certain time is paid at time and a half, and I did that this year and it was fun. I got to meet new people and of course the pay was great. So that's something to look into. But it is, you know, right before Thanksgiving night. So if you have plans to cook really early in the morning, it's not something that you would do. Or if you're not cooking and you're just going over to a friend's house or family just to go eat, maybe you should look into doing this right before Thanksgiving. So not all places do the decorating party. So for example, an outlet store. Outlet stores, however, do offer Black Friday hours. So if you are okay with working on Thanksgiving Day or going in after Thanksgiving dinner and working those late hours, AM hours, where, you know, people are coming in, you know, at 1 a.m., 2 a.m., 3 a.m., what have you, then I would suggest this option to you. Instead of shopping on Black Friday and buying things that you probably don't need, you should work the extra hours. Well, I think that's something I agree with and something that Akiva might agree with. And I don't know about Meshach though, because he does do Black Friday, but I think Black Friday is a hoax. Just me. It's just what I believe. So I don't know. Don't come for me in the comments. It's just a personal opinion. I'm gonna touch a little bit about what types of positions there are. So if you do go into retail, most of them can be commission type jobs. And if you're not into that kind of like pushy salesman, you know, persona, then I wouldn't recommend that to you. But there are other seasonal jobs that you could do. I know that at Bloomingdale's, they had like a gift wrapping position where you basically make boxes, or you're at a station where you're wrapping up items and products for people as gifts. You can also sign up for receiving and shipping, where you receive items or you send back items. You can work at their fulfillment centers. There's also positions, if you don't want to work at a register pushing items and selling items, you can work at a service desk where you just do returns and just do customer service. And another position that you could do, if you don't want to do that either, you can work for the for the department's web team. Usually big department stores have a team that works on fulfilling web orders, so that's probably like, and what that is going on a scavenger hunt for items that are on the sales floor, and you get those items, you pack them, and then ship them off to where they need to go, or pack them, what have you, and send them on their merry way. I've only done this 2 years. Last year I did a couple months of seasonal work at an outlet store, and I got in some hours during Black Friday, and I was very tired. I think I worked 2 to 3 days straight with like 4 to 3 hours in between my shifts of sleep. I also had done Black Friday hours at a food restaurant kind of type thing. And I also had to close and open the store and clean up, and it's obviously more work. And now I'm doing retail work. So I don't have a lot of experience to offer you, but I do know that these are the tips that I looked into before I applied. If you've done some seasonal work, please comment below. Let us know what worked for you. Where did you find it to be great to work as a seasonal job? We would love to know. And I know that our community would love to share stories. This is for you guys. We look forward to reading your comments and finding out what worked best for you guys. That's it for today. And I hope we see you tomorrow in tomorrow's Vlogmas episode. Bye. I forgot what I was gonna say. Okay, next. Let me think, hold on. What's the other one? We're gonna do that one more time.